to jump out of an airplane.
You're going to jump out at 6,000?
And I'm actually going to fly down without a chute for a moment.
All right, any redirect, Mr. Finnerty?
Yes, Your Honor. Mrs. Garrett, Janet had been living at home how long before the accident last October 20th?
Approximately 6 months.
Did you see and talk to her every day during that time?
Yes.
And when Mrs. Howard came to visit you during that time, did you and she ever talk about Janet?
Occasionally.
And on the day that she smashed her car into a tree, isn't it true that Mrs. Howard told you that she was going to injure or kill herself or someone else unless you put her in a clinic to dry out?
I don't recall her saying that.
You don't deny it, do you?
It wouldn't surprise me.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and...
And more temperate? The 17th sonnet. Do I pass, Professor?
I think it was Shakespeare's 18th.
You think? You know.
Judy, you never told me you work with such lovely ladies.
She was right. He is perfect.
Dennis is a very successful social worker, a notary public, won a gold medal in the 76 Olympics, and once saved a room full of orphans from a burning building.
I'll never forgive myself for not getting the flag out in time.
Do you have any friends named Jimmy Olsen?
Oh, what a delight.
cool sense of humor. Why don't I get us some refreshing beverages?
Oh.
Virgin Mary's all around?
Especially here.
The very thought of you and I forget to do the little ordinary things that everyone ought to do. I'm living in a kind of daydream. I'm happy as a king and foolish though it may seem to me, that's everything, the mere idea of you. Longing here for you, you'll never know how slow the moments go till I'm near to you. I see your face in every flower, your eyes and stars above. It's just the thought of you, the very thought of you, my love.
Welcome back to the program. Now, the reality is you can't come to California and not come to Los Angeles, specifically West Hollywood, because that's where Brad lives.
Hello, Brad. Welcome to the program.
Hi.
Thanks,
nice
sir,
to see
for
you.
Being here.
Thank you.
Well, what a nice party you dialed up for us here.
Well, I got wine. That's a good thing right there.
That's a step one.
Wine
right
is a winner. Big
right.
Time winner. One time I went into the Elton John Oscar party. I thought I was cool. I had my tuxedo. I'm not a famous face.
Right, you had your pink glasses.
Well, no, not even that. The experience was, could I get some more wine? Or could I get some more? They thought I was a waiter. So I'm not part of that culture,
there.
So I worked there.
That's funny.
You are the apple of my eye. the somber yet beautiful strains of America the Beautiful being played by a military band, which followed taps and the three shots heard in the rifle volley. Right now, you're looking at the family of Charles Chick Burlingame, again, the pilot who was flying American Airlines Flight 77 from Dulles to Los Angeles when it hit the Pentagon as a result of the terrorist activity on board that plane. It hit at 9:43 a.m. exactly 3 months ago, yesterday.
His birthday was September 12th, and he was going to celebrate by going to the Angels game because he was a huge Angels fan and loved the Lakers as well. And he had actually wanted his wife, Sherry, who lives in Virginia, to come with him to Los Angeles, but he couldn't get good seats for the game. Yeah. So he decided that she should, in fact, stay at home.
Over the years, Chick would come out to California, and he'd come out here, and a few days in advance, he and I would try to plan on going to a game, and it was typically whether or not we could get good seats or not. And because he graduated from Anaheim High School, right where the Angels play, and so he was a longtime Angel fan and Lakers fan as well.
So low, The moonlight started showing, but then I saw you somewhere in the distance. You said, how are you? You're not gonna wanna miss this when the sun goes down. I'll think of you now, and when the moon comes up, I won't turn around. I'll just stare at the darkness, and I'll think of you there, way across the distance of that star-filled air. And I know I'll see you in my dreams. 'Cause sometimes things may flee you, but they never ever leave. Oh, I'll see you, I'll see you, I'll see you in my dreams. I'll see you, I'll see you, I'll see you.